Jewish people just want to see the innocent people brought back home.
I just came here to asking for ceasefire because so many innocent people are dying.
In Sydney, Brisbane and Melbourne, they rallied in their thousands. Today's peaceful protests in stark contrast to ugly scenes in Sydney yesterday. Led by Zaki Mallah, convicted of terrorism offences in 2003, a pro-Palestinian motorcade condemned by Jewish and Palestinian leaders alike.
There is obviously a right to protest, a right to rally, whatever one's belief is, but it cannot be done in a way that intimidates people, that incites violence or that incites hate.
This is a deliberately provocative action. It has no strategic purpose. No one I know in the Palestinian community is on board with this.
Sydney's demonstration following a Melbourne protest sparked by the firebombing of a burger restaurant. The Palestinian owner spotted at a pro-Palestine rally.
I am confident that this is not religiously or politically motivated.
Those assurances weren't enough for protesters who triggered the evacuation of a nearby synagogue after moving to a local park.
To hold a pro-Palestinian rally in that area has an element of intimidation about it.
Violence erupting between pro-Palestinian and pro-Israeli groups as ugly brawling saw police break out the pepper spray.
Organisers were unaware that there was a synagogue across the park. We apologise to the local Jewish community. It was never our intention to disrupt or intimidate Jewish worshippers.
Our community is terrified across the board. The anti-Semitism must stop. That's a non-negotiable. We need to feel safe.
Communities on both sides feeling vulnerable as divisions deepen.
We love you, Gaza!
We love you, Gaza!
We love you, Gaza!
Amal Naser is from the Palestinian Action Group, which helped organise today's rally in Sydney. Amal, the rallies we saw today were peaceful, but yesterday we saw racist hate speech in one Sydney protest, as well as violent clashes in Melbourne. Are you concerned about how that reflects on the broader Palestinian movement?
I'm not too concerned, as these are fringes of a movement, and it's more so reflective on the government's response to the war, with ASIO warning that the government's inaction and isolation of the Palestinian and Arab community is fueling community division. So I think it's more so a reflection on the government's current behaviour and statements that they're making.
These people are marching and protesting in the name of Palestine. Do you ever engage with these fringes to try and modify this inflammatory behaviour?
For example, yesterday at Coogee, we weren't really aware of who was organising them. If we were, we would have made attempts to try to have them not go towards that area. But the police handled it, and they handled it quite well, in my view.
Amal, as the conflict drags on in the Middle East, are you concerned at all about how the protests here will develop?
I think the protests are successfully developing in response to the conflict. As the death toll in Gaza grows, we're seeing more and more people out on the streets in peaceful demonstrations. We saw around 60,000 people in Hyde Park today, and 5 weeks in, our protests are still growing. They're not slowing down, which is a reflection that the Australian community oppose the current genocide in Gaza and oppose our government's position on it.
As an organiser, when protests threaten to turn violent, what do you do to manage that?
Thankfully, in our main rallies, we haven't seen threats of violence so far, but we work very closely with police in the planning stage, and as we go towards the rallies, to avoid areas that may be inflammatory, to avoid clashing with counter-protesters, and we have really strong marshalling teams to just ensure that everything remains peaceful and safe for our attendees and for the general community.
I'm interested in community cohesion, Amal, and what your thoughts are on that, because even at some of these rallies where it is peaceful, there are still chants of things like from the river to the sea, down, Israel. Do you understand why some Jewish Australians now feel quite intimidated, quite scared about what's going on our streets?
From the river to the sea is a chant of liberation. It's about ensuring that every Palestinian, who lives in Palestine and in Israel, from the Mediterranean River to the Jordanian Sea, have equal rights and live with freedom, which at the moment is not the case.
I totally understand that may be your view of what that means, but clearly to many Jews, that's interpreted as no space for Jews between the river and the sea, that this is part of an acknowledgement that Israel doesn't have a right to exist. I know you'll differ in your view of that, but it's fair to say many interpret it that way. Do you understand why there might be fears?
Well, we've made it very clear that that's not our position. I don't understand from the river to the sea, in my view, and in the views of the organisers, and we've made it very clear, is a chant of liberation. It's about freedom, it's about peace, and it's about equality. And I think it is coming because the government has made statements that are not... That are a bit insightful and are dividing communities even further, and that's the view of ASIO as well.
Amal Naser, thanks so much for your time tonight. We appreciate it.
Thank you.